Hi, my name is Gala, and today I would like to review my Google Data Studio template that called Spend Tracking Template. It is really nice. I created this report for one of my clients. Then I changed data sources, changed numbers, changed data source names, and now it is just template with random data. So it could be far from reality, but anyway, it is nice template, and we don't need real numbers. We need charts and the logic of the report. This report has three pages: total ads page, ads by type, and ads by platform. And as usual, we start to observe the main KPIs that we have. So the main KPI that we have here, it is a totally monthly budget. And we can see budget for 2021, 2022, and select month that we are interested in. Actually, it's nice because usually I use date range picker, but here in this report, I decided to use two filters for years and for months. It's really interesting because it is another option in Google Data Studio. How can we use date range filter? So it's really comfortable for this case. And what we can see here, the first metric, it is a total budget. It is our planning budget. And we say that, okay, we have $10,000 for ads for July 2022. And we know that we would like to spend this budget, split this budget by Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, and Microsoft ads. And the second row means that if we continue to spend for ads as we do till now, in the end of month, we will spend 28% less than we should, and 28% less for Facebook, and etc. So this percentage means if we continue to pay for ads how we do it now, for the 31st of July, we will spend less than we have. It is better than spend more than we have, but anyway, it is out of plan. So I would correct ads strategy and review ads in this case. Then we have percent current spend till today from the month plan. This means that till now, till today, today is 25th of July, we spent 72% of our monthly budget. In this case, will be $7,200 we spent today. So, but we could spend more because you see, we spend less than we can. So this radar shows us how much money did we spend already, in fact. This is really nice chart, spending trajectory, that contains total spend, planning daily spend total, and trajectory total. If you see this black line, it is a monthly limit. It is 9. Okay, I don't know why it is 9, because we have 10,000 budget. Anyway, so the black line, it is a planning monthly limit. So this line shows us how much we can spend. Then we have this green line, and this one. This line, it is a current spending. So how much, like, how do we spend money till today? And we see that this line goes here, and on 25th of July, it's continued to go straight, because today is 25th of July, and of course, from today, we didn't spend money. And the dark green line means plan and daily spend. So by plan, we should spend money like this. So better if this light green line stays close to the dark green line. It means that we are on a budget. And here you see that the planning budget line goes upper than real spending, so we don't spend money as we should. And total trajectory line means that if we continue to spend money like today, in the end of months we will spend this money. So I think it's really useful because it on one chart you can see your current situation with your ads. And this is of course for all ads, this chart for all ads. And but we have different platforms, so we should have charts for different platforms to see how each platform works. So we have smaller charts, but actually it's absolutely the same logic. So this is Facebook spend, Twitter spend, charts for TikTok spend, and Microsoft ad spend. Exactly the same logic, exactly the same lines. So plan, real spend, plan and spend, and trajectory spend. If we go down, we can see another section of the report, total ads overview. And here we can see our data by month. So how our ads are going on during the long period. And here we have, like, again, we have only main metric in this report. We have revenue, we have spend, and ROAS. And we can compare revenue with ROAS and see that, okay, some months it was goes up, some months goes down, and it's really nice to see. And next we see the table with the same data that on charts, but on the table. So because sometimes it's nicer to see data on the tables, because sometimes because here you can see numbers, here you don't see numbers. Anyway, then okay, here is a chart with we take revenue for this report from Google Analytics, and this revenue takes this chart takes revenue from Google Analytics from only channels that we use in the report, and these charts take revenue from Google Analytics from all channels. So this is a difference, but in the end the charts are the same, and just a bit difference between how do we calculate Google Analytics revenue. If we go to the second page, we can go deeper to details and split our, so on the first page we did like overview of our business, what is going on, la la la. Here on the second page, we go a bit deeper and check ROAS by platforms and see detailed table with different channels. Then we have section with Facebook data only, then we have section with Instagram, this Instagram section only, then Twitter section only, TikTok section only. Here on the first page we didn't split Facebook and Instagram for two platforms. Here we split it by platforms because it's nice to see the difference between Instagram and Facebook. And on the third page we continue to review our channels, and here in the beginning we can see comparison plan and fact for all social ads and for Microsoft ads. So we split our ads channel for social media platforms and paid per click platforms, and this is a common data for social data and for Microsoft. Then again, as we did before, we do analysis for social ads platform together, and Microsoft Ads platform. That is it. This is our report. I think it's really nice and it's really useful when you work with different ads platform. It's really nice to use. Let's check one more thing here. Let's click to edit. Go to resources. We take data from Google Sheets. I can click to edit and edit and go to pam pam pam. Oh, I'm sorry, sometimes it's loading. And total ads. Okay, I created Google Sheets document for these ads. And these Google Sheets documents take data from different platforms and report from here to Google Data Studio. This platform, or this Google Sheets, contains several tabs. For example, the first tab, it is a budget tab where we have budget for different platforms. And we do some calculations here already. For example, I calculate spend split budget. I can calculate percentage. I can calculate daily budget and plan in daily budget. Then we have pivot table for total ads. If we click here, we can see, it is pivot table that takes data from total ads tab. Actually, interesting. I think I created this pivot table just to compare data with Google Data Studio. Our working table, it is total ads tab. Here we merge data from different platforms, from Facebook, from Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, etc. Then we have tab separate for social media platforms, and then we have some tabs with data from different platforms. So in this case, it's data from Google Analytics about revenue, data from ads campaigns, and so on. So we pull data from different, in this case, we use Supermetrics add-on and pull data from different campaigns, different platforms, and combine here in this tab and connect this tab to Google Data Studio. In this project, I used Supermetrics add-on, this one, because we have some platforms like TikTok or Twitter, and there are not a lot of connectors pull data from this platform. So, and I selected Supermetrics for this task. I think that is it, what I wanted to tell you, what I wanted to explain you today. So, please feel free to ask me questions. I think this template is nice and it's really useful. And I just want to repeat that the logic is we pull data using Supermetrics to Google Sheets from different platforms. Then we combine data from different platforms in one tab, add to this tab information about the budget. It's here on the planning columns. You see it is like formulas that bring data from budget tab. And that is it. And this table, it's only one that we connect to Google Data Studio and have this nice report. Hope you like it. Let me know if you like it or not, if you like this template. You can try to create your own report based on this video, or you can ask me to create a report for you if you need help. So feel free, subscribe to my channel, and see you soon.